Dear students, I am Dr. Rajiv Sapre and this is the 54th audio for you. In this audio, I will talk about very important method of proof, and it is called method of induction. Okay. See, in any result that we want to prove in mathematics, varieties of methods of proofs are followed. Predictive logic is one method. It means whatever is given, from that you go on developing logically the proof and finally reach to the required result. That is called direct proof. See, in every mathematical statement, something is given and something we have to prove. P implies Q type statements. So we always start with P and do the logical growth and finally reach to Q. This is called direct proof. Another method of proof is indirect. There is something called contrapositive statement. It means when P implies Q, this is called implication. Remember, P implies Q type of statements are called implications. And logically, we can prove that negation of Q implies negation of P, and this P implies Q, they are logically equivalent. So proving P implies Q and proving negation of P, negation of Q implies negation of P is same. So sometimes what is done is, instead of proving P implies Q, you prove not Q implies not P. That also is a valid proof and it is called indirect proof. Okay. Third method, you have also done, and that is called contradictory method. That means, suppose I am given something and I have to prove something. You assume that it is not true. Right? You assume that it is not true. And then develop the proof. Somewhere we will come to some absurd result, contradictory result, and then you will say our assumption is wrong and the statement is true. These are the ways. Okay, so varieties of ways are there. These are not the only three methods of proof, but you will come across, whatever mathematics you will study up to the end of 12th standard, you will come across these types of proofs. Logical proof. Secondly, contrapositive method of proving the results. Third is contradiction method. And now you are going to learn one excellent method of proof. And it is called method of induction. Only thing is, this method of induction is used to prove the properties of positive integers, properties of natural numbers. You cannot use this method of induction to prove any property of real number, any properties of complex numbers. No. Restriction is properties of positive integers can be proved by using method of induction. But it is the best method, very logical proof, very logical method of proving any property of positive integers. See, sometimes what happens is, some results are guessed by observing some pattern and then proved or disproved. One example I will give. If I have to find sum of first n odd natural numbers, we will observe the pattern. If I take only one odd natural number, it is 1. So, its sum will be 1, which I can write as 1 square also, because 1 is same as 1 square. If you take first 2 odd natural numbers, they are 1 and 3, their addition is 4, so it is 2 square. If I take first 3 natural numbers, then it is 1 plus 3 plus 5, So it is 9, and 9 is 3 square. If I take first 4 odd natural numbers, it is 1 plus 3 plus 5 plus 7, addition is 16, which is 4 square, and so on. So we observe some pattern in this. Whenever I take first two odd natural numbers and add, I get 2 square. When I get first 3 odd natural numbers and add, I get 3 square. So my guess can be sum of first n odd natural numbers will be n square. That means what I want to say is 1 plus 3 plus 5 plus and so on up to 2n minus 1. 2n minus 1 is the nth odd number, right? So that sum will be n square. This is just my observation. But remember, dear students, this is not the proof. This is just a guess, because for first 4 or 5 odd natural numbers, I have found this pattern. But this particular observation is not a proof. From these 4 or 5 things that you have verified, you cannot say that this is true for all natural numbers. Right? So in short, by observing these 4 or 5 things that you have done, you cannot concretely tell that sum of first n odd natural numbers will be n square. You will require to prove it. And remember, you cannot prove this by considering all odd natural numbers, because that number is infinite. Right? So you have done it for first one natural number only, two odd natural numbers, first 3 odd natural numbers, first 4 odd natural numbers, and that's all. You observed some pattern. But this pattern, and from that whatever general result you have developed, is just an observation. It is not the proof. Right? By this way, you concretely cannot say that it is a proof. Another example we will discuss. If n is a natural number and it is not divisible by 3, okay, then is 10n plus 3, 10 into n plus 3 is a prime number? See, we have to take a natural number which is not divisible by 3. So start with 1. So it is 10 into n plus 3 will become 10 into 1 plus 3, which is 13, prime number. If you take n is 2, 2 is not divisible by 3, so I can take n as 2. Now what is 10n plus 3? It will be 23, it's a prime number. That means we are taking n 2, no, so 10 into n plus 3 will be 10 into 2 plus 3, so it is 23, it is a prime number. Then n is 3 we will not take, because it is divisible by 3. So now go to n is equal to 4. Now calculate 10 into n plus 3, that is 10 into 4 plus 3, which is 43, prime number. Then you go for n is equal to 5. Then 10 into n, 5 I can take because 5 is not divisible by 3. Then 10 into 5 plus 3 will be 53, it is a prime number. So from these 4 or 5 things that we have done, we may guess that if n is not divisible by 3, then 10n plus 3 is a prime number for all n. But this is an adventurous statement. We have not verified all natural numbers which are not divisible by 3. Are you getting? So if you proceed like this, then when you come to n is 13, because 13 is also not divisible by 3, then 10 into n plus 3, that is 10 into 13 plus 3, which is 133. Right? 133 is not a prime number. You can verify 133 is not a prime number. So what you guess from all this is that the statement 10n plus 3 is a prime number when n is not divisible by 3 is not true. So this result is disproved. Okay. Hence, we cannot just guess or we cannot prove the result by observing some particular cases, some finite number of cases. You take, your result is proved there. That does not mean the result is always true for every natural number. But the thing is that you cannot go to every natural number and prove or verify the result and finally declare that, okay, the result is true for all n. This is not possible because n natural number set is infinite. So it is highly impossible to go to every element and check the required, check the property that you are trying to prove. Right? So there must be some method by which this can be done, and the answer to this question is the method of induction. Answer to that question is method of induction. Now, what is done in this method of induction? As I told in the beginning, that this method is solely used to prove the properties of positive integers. Okay. So now what is this principle of mathematical induction? Let P in bracket n be the statement associated with every natural number n. That is why that bracketed n is written. P in bracket n. P stands for a property. N stands for the natural number. So let Pn be the statement associated with every natural number. Now if this result is true for 1, why 1? Because 1 is the first natural number. So we will check that whether this result is true for n is equal to 1. Okay. So if the statement is true for n is equal to 1, and secondly, if the statement is true for n is equal to k, implies statement is true for n is equal to k plus 1. This is an important phase. If the statement is true for n is equal to k, it implies it is true for n is equal to k plus 1. Then we can say in general the property is true for all n. Now why this? See, you are proving that property is true for n is equal to 1, which is the first natural number. And in second step, we are proving if the property is true for k, it is true for k plus 1. Now see, this is important. When the property is true for k, it is true for k plus 1. What does it mean? Already you proved that result is true for 1. So this, if k is taken as 1, it is true for k plus 1, that means for 2. So when is the result true for n is equal to 1? It is also true for n is equal to 2. As it is true for n is equal to 2, it is also true for n is equal to 3. When it is true for n is equal to 3, it is also true for n is equal to 4, and so on. Because you have proved general statement, when the property is true for k, it is true for k plus 1. Right? So this is a beautiful method by which you can prove any property of positive natural numbers. Okay, so now what will be the working rule for this? Working rule goes in three different steps. You, whatever property you have to prove, let it be Pn. Pn be the given property. Now you prove that property for n is equal to 1. Prove the property means what? Put n is equal to 1 in that property and see whether the statement is true. After that is done, second step is you assume that property is true for n is equal to k. Assume, you have not to prove here anything. Assume that property is true for n is equal to k. And then third step is important. Using the second part, that means you are assuming that property is true for n is equal to k, you prove that property is true for n is equal to k plus 1. So when n property is true for k, it implies property is true for k plus 1. You prove this. Right? And in proving this, one thing is very important. In proving this part, you have to somewhere use the assumption that you have made, that property is true for n is equal to k. If you claim that you have proved the third part without using the assumption that property is true for n is equal to k, 100% you are wrong. In this method of induction, this is important that the assumption that you are making that property is true for n is equal to k is to be used in the last part of the proof. So this is very interesting method of proving and very powerful technique of proving any property for positive integers. Okay, I hope you enjoyed this audio. Thank you.